Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to be taking you through how to create an exam or a quiz, like a midterm or a final exam, a practice exam, any exams you want to take and create here on Canvas for your students. So let me dive right in. The first thing you want to do is go down to the quizzes tab on the left side of your browser. That exact tab and made it active. If you need more information on the settings, I did a video all about this. I'll link it up in the cards here for you as well. So this is an example of a class that I just completed that was face-to-face and then went online. So the final exam was online. This is what a final exam looks like after you create it. Very similar to when we were creating modules and assignments, but this is going to be a quiz or an exam. So this was their final exam, and this is what it really looks like after you create it. All the information is in here, just like we were setting up any other pages in our previous videos. If this is your first time seeing this video, check out all the other videos that I've created up to this point for creating your Canvas class. I'll link it up the playlist in the cards for you as well. Okay, so here's all the information, and then you can preview it. And you can see what it looks like on my end. So this is just a preview version of it. They've already taken it. That's why you're seeing this message at the top. And then I've created the questions, and this one I just made it multiple choice. I made it very, very simple for them. All the questions are in here. You can see on the right, it counts them down. It also counts down the time that they'll have that you assign to them. And then at the very bottom, after they go through all of the questions, they hit submit quiz, and then that completes their, this was their final exam. Here's another example, because I always like to show you examples before we dive into actually doing it, so you can see what the finished product is. Here is an online class I did a while back. These are their quizzes. So I did a quiz at the end of every unit. Every module had a quiz. They also had a midterm and a final exam. I'll talk about some other options you have at the very end of this as well, which is end of the semester surveys that you can do. I did a test quiz over in this class before their final exam. I did a practice exam, so they got the idea of how an exam would actually going to work. So it kind of calms their anxiety just a bit. But let me show you, here's another example. So this is a quiz, and it was just over 3 chapters, the end of a module. I popped a little funny image in there for them, make it more fun for them. And then you can see this one was a quiz over introduction to theater. It was only, it looks like 20 questions long because it was just a quiz. There's multiple choice in here. You can also do true and false, all kinds of other examples, but this is what it looks like to them. It's really user friendly. So let's go ahead and go back and let's create a quiz. So first thing you want to do, of course, is go over here to the top right bar, and it's blue, it's the blue plus button, click add quiz. Okay, this opens up, and this is going to be at first very similar to any other page that we've been creating in a module or any assignment. Again, you're going to see the more you do this, you'll discover the interface is very similar. So again, you would want to name the quiz, or maybe it's a quiz and exam is really the same platform here, but you can title them different. So maybe this is your midterm exam or your final exam, or it's a quiz, or it's quiz number one, or unit one quiz, whatever you want to name it. Again, put in a brief description in here so they know exactly what it is. Here is an example, quizzes. Here is an example of kind of what I do. I make sure I lay everything out for them. I make sure they know exactly what I want. So I wrote in here, please select the correct answer for each question. This is a timed quiz. You will have 20 minutes to finish it. Keep track of your time by looking at the clock on the right. You can take the quiz 2 times. The highest score will be used. Good luck. Click the take quiz button below to begin. Lay it out for them, and I'll show you how to include all of this information that I just described. But after you figure out your format that works for you, for each individual quiz or exam or test, write all of that in here. So before they even start and submit it, they know what to expect. Okay, so write your description in here. So description, to describe it in this box, whatever you want. Again, you can add photos or videos, add images over here if you'd like, what I've done before. But keep this one simple, okay? Now here are your settings. Graded quiz. Is it going to be a practice quiz, a graded quiz, a survey that's graded, or an ungraded survey? I do like to create practice quizzes for them that's not graded, but that gives them the idea of what it's going to be like. So really great idea to do that, maybe 5 questions, and it's just a way for them to practice. So say this is a graded quiz. I'm going to do this for my midterm exam. Okay, assignment group, where do you want it to land? I always put it in exams, or if you've created a quiz, wherever you want to put it. So where it's going to be housed here on Canvas. Okay, do you want the questions, the answers shuffled? I would click that yes. And the reason why is because if there are students sitting side by side taking this, you don't want them to be able to go down and go through and communicate next to each other. Or if brother and sister are taking it together and it's a K through 12 class, if it's a group of students in college class and they all want to sit around together, it's just easier to shuffle it. That way nobody's quiz looks the same. Time limit. You want to give them a time limit if it's a graded quiz or exam. If it's ungraded, you could take that time limit off. If it's a practice quiz and they're prepping for one that's going to be timed, time it. The reason why you want to time it is because, of course, when they're working remotely, they can be sitting here taking this exam with all of their notes, all of their books, with anybody else helping them around. That's just the nature of an online class, unfortunately. So how long do you want it to be? I have discovered over time, depending on who you're teaching, that if I do a 50-minute question and it's multiple choice, true and false, if it's 50 questions, multiple choice, true and false, I give them 30 minutes. You don't want to give them a lot of time because they're going to be pulling notes and books and tests and whatnot. So keep that in mind. So say you want it to be 50 minutes. Allow multiple attempts. Do you want them to be able to take this more than one time? I would say yes. I give them 2 times to take it, and this is for college students. And I let them keep the highest score, but you have options here, the highest score, and then how many times do you want them to be able to take it? I let them take it for 2 times, and this is just what I choose. You're going to have to practice and play around and see what works and what doesn't work. And the grades will tell you that as well. So let students see their responses. I like to do it after their last attempt. And again, this is for my college students. Do you want them to only once after each attempt? Let the students see the correct answers. When do you want them to do it? You can fill this in as you see fit. Show questions one at a time. This means that the students see the questions one at a time versus scrolling down through it. I don't preferably click that box because I like the students to go fast or slow, and I've just gotten the response from the students that it's better if the way I've been doing it, which is they see everything at one time. Require an access code. If you want to restrict this and give them a password, you can. I don't normally do this. Up to you. I wouldn't worry about filtering any of the IP addresses unless you're really advanced. Then you can dive into that later. Again, assigned to everyone or certain groups of folks. You can do that in here as well. When do you want it to be due? Pick your due date. You want that to line up with the until date as well. Okay, so available from, when do you want them to be able to start taking it? And when do you want them it to close where they can't take it anymore? I would say give them a good window of time. You never know what a student is dealing with if they only have computer access at certain times of the day, if they share computers. Make sure you give them at least a couple of days. I like to give them a week if I'm teaching an 18-week class, but again, that's completely up to you. All you have to do at the bottom is click save, or you click the save and publish button if you're ready for the students to see it. Remember, until you click publish, they're not going to see it. So you'd click save, and then you would have the basic format. The next thing you want to do is add in all of the content. And this is really the most time-consuming part at the beginning. So click on questions at the very top up here, okay? And then you can click new question, and then write in the box here what you want the question to be. You can bold this, you can use all of these extra elements up here. You can also add a photo if you want to embed an image, or click images over here. You can add a link. I would discourage doing a link where they jump out of it, but if you want to add a YouTube video and have them watch a video, and then the answer, the question is, who is being interviewed in this video? What artist is being interviewed? Or what painting is being shown? Again, just copy and paste the link to the YouTube video. It will pop in here. It will pop right in this box. And then it will be accessible because it will have the closed captions on it for those folks that need that. Whatever you want your question to be, put it in here. Put in the correct answer. Will always be this green one on the top. So you would type in this answer at the top. Okay, so this would be Stephen Sondheim. And then these are the other possible answers. So you would put the incorrect answers here. Okay, so Carol Channing's already up here. Stephen Schwartz is already in here. Okay, fill these in. Richard Rogers. Okay, fill all of those in and then click update question and it will be saved. Okay, so I'll click update question, why not? Okay, so here's my first question. Okay, now you could also do new question. You could also, at the top up here, you have some options. So that was multiple choice as the default. You can do true and false. You can have them fill in the blank, fill in multiple blanks, multiple answers, a drop-down menu. You can have them do matching, an answer that's a number, a formula question. You can also do an essay question where they have to write a paragraph or make them upload. What I do is I stick to something that's quite simple at first until you've done these types of essays and these types of quizzes and exams, and the students are also used to taking them. I stick to multiple choice, true and false, and then sometimes I will do an essay question where I have them describe the themes of the musical Oklahoma and how it still is affecting society today. Or whatever. So you just click on that and it will change. So if I'm doing true and false, it will change down here to true or false. So you have these different options to kind of set up as you wish. Okay, so all of those are housed up here in the arrow buttons. After you fill in all of your information, make sure you click save. If you're working on this step by step in little parts at a time, which I really encourage you to do, is always click save after every 5 or 10 minutes so you don't lose anything. If you don't click save and you've done 20 questions and something happens to your computer, you're gonna lose everything. So just make sure that you're saving kind of every 5 or 10 minutes as you go and then go back in and editing everything, okay? Now, notice at the top here, it says it's not published, okay? Once you're ready to publish this, for example, here's quizzes again. Once you're ready to publish it, you can go over here on your main module screen in quizzes and you can click the green button. If I unclick this, then it will not be green. So you would notice that it's not published. Okay, when you're ready for them to publish it, you can click this and then it will open for them on the dates that you have set. So if you want to go ahead and publish it, it won't even launch until you've made it available to them in the dates and the settings. Some other options that you have are practice exams. Here's an example of a practice exam that I did. It's 5 questions, highest score. I set it all up for them. Another option that you have is going to be to create end of semester surveys. So this is a survey that I created. Again, the quiz type was ungraded survey when I picked it and dropped the bar down. So you have this opportunity as well to create it so that you can get feedback from your students. I found this really helpful for me that they gave me feedback and I knew what worked or didn't work for them. I asked them certain questions. It wasn't graded, but certain questions like, was the course content effectively organized? Were the course ideas well constructed in a clear, understandable manner? And then I put agree, disagree, and I put a form for them to choose. And it was really, really helpful for me to get feedback for them. And I make this due at the end of the semester. I even make it optional where they don't even have to do it. But it really did help me, and I noticed that I was able to understand what they needed on their side. So consider doing that as well. So that is everything for quizzes. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. And happy creating your quiz or your exam. I will see you in the next video. Bye.